I also don't think resiliency is like really a big problem for this deck. We're gonna keep this, even though the Nyx Fleece Rams don't have a way of turning on. I think they're still solid in this matchup. So what we want to see from our opponent here is a cantrip, but I would also take a Swift Spear. Okay, so he's gonna hit me for one. So many Rams. I'm just gonna play this because I want to fetch a land. I'm gonna play Taft, and I don't have anything to do on turn one anyway. It's gonna give me a Temple Garden, and then on turn two, I can play a Ram, and hopefully that resolves. The bad thing about Ram is that it doesn't. Is that Young Pyromancer can like make a horde through it. Yeah, he's just playing a Young Pyromancer, so I'm probably just gonna kill that on turn two instead of playing a Ram. I don't want to like get in time to generate an army. But I think the incidental life gain in this matchup is good. I don't know, we'll see. If I actually have time to play all these sheep and have them do something, then another Pyromancer? Okay. And like, is playing sheep necessarily better than playing Goyf here? I don't think so. Nice thing about Goyf is that it prevents attacks. Okay, he's fetching. Looks like it's getting snared. Shock self. Yeah, there's no reason to shock yourself unless you're snaring there. Pretty bad sign for the old home team. I think we'll be alright if we draw a land fairly soon here. And I think he would have snared Ram, too. It's impossible to know for sure, but anyway. Hope this isn't a third Young Pyromancer. One nice thing about the Lingering Souls build is that you got to main deck Zealous Persecution. The Lingering Souls build of Junk is that you get to main deck Zealous Persecution, which is really good against Young Pyromancer and friends. But I wasn't sure if it was quite good enough in other matchups. So he's cruising. I mean, he's got. Yeah, that's exactly what he's doing. So we're in. I'm not gonna lie to you folks. We're in pretty rough shape here. The board presence is too strong. I was considering sideboarding a Drown in Sorrow, but I mean, we don't even have the third land for that card. We are just taking the beat down. Goyf resolves, kind of unexpectedly. The reason I played Goyf instead of Nyx Fleece Ram here is because if he's going to send, like if I just play the Ram, he can just attack with everything with no repercussions. Whereas if I play Goyf, maybe he can't send in his Young Pyromancer. Maybe he doesn't want to send in his Elementals if I'm going to eat one. Another Swift Spear. So he's down to three cards in hand. Two cards in hand after his land drop. Three mana for a Hibernation. Is that lethal? I think that's close enough to lethal. I could play comes into play untapped land and double Ram. I guess playing Ram here would have kept me from dying because I could just block here. But I'm certainly dead. Well, maybe I don't want to show him that I'm dead. Okay, well now I'm literally dead, whereas before I would just be dead next turn. Anyway. Well, that sucked. I mean, our hand was kind of a clunker-rooney. I can't believe those words just came out of my mouth. Minus Duress, plus Inquisition on the play. Yeah, that seems fine. I'm still good with these other cuts. Engineered Explosives might be a little clunky for what we're trying to beat. Maybe Pulse is more elegant. I don't know.